Let's begin with an exercise. Determine the solution of the differential equation dy dt equals 2y that satisfies y of 0 equals 1. In this video, we need to find the formula ourselves, but at the end of the video, we'll discuss a shortcut based on the formula we derive. Before we solve this, it's worth noting that the differential equation dy dt equals 2y is different than the differential equation dy dt equals 2t. To solve this differential equation, you might think we could integrate both sides to undo the derivative, and that's correct. Integrating, we obtain y equals the integral of 2t dt, which is equal to 2 times t squared over 2 plus c, which simplifies to t squared plus c. On the other hand, solving dy dt equals 2y is a bit more complicated. With this equation, we cannot integrate immediately. Since y is an unknown function of t, we don't know what the integral of 2y dt is. Okay, then how do we solve this differential equation? Well, it might take a little bit of trial and error to get the right idea, but one thing you might try is dividing both sides by y, because then you end up with just 2 on the right-hand side, and that we do know how to integrate. And we can divide by y as long as y is not 0. Later, we'll deal with the case when y is equal to 0. Of course, that leaves the question, can we integrate the left-hand side? It may not be obvious at first, but you might remember from calculus that the derivative of ln of the absolute value of y is equal to 1 over y, and then because of the chain rule, we have to multiply by the derivative of the inner function, which is dy dt. This is exactly the left-hand side of the equation. In other words, the left-hand side is a derivative, and we can integrate to undo the derivative and then solve for y. Integrating, we get that the ln of the absolute value of y equals the integral of 2, which is 2t plus c. Since y is inside of the natural logarithm, we can exponentiate both sides to get that the absolute value of y equals e to the 2t plus c. At this point, it's helpful to simplify things a little bit, and one way to do this is to recognize that we can split up the right-hand side using a property of exponents into two factors, e to the 2t and e to the c. That might not look much simpler, but let's think carefully about this. If c can be any real number, then what is e to the c? To answer this question, it will help us to consider the graph of y equals e to the x, which looks like this. Notice that since c can be any real number, e to the c can be any number in the range of e to the x. The graph reminds us that the range of e to the x consists of all real numbers greater than 0. Therefore, e to the c can be any positive real number, and we can replace it with an arbitrary positive constant, which we'll call c2. Next, we want to isolate y, and we know that if the absolute value of y equals c2 e to the 2t, then y equals plus or minus c2 e to the 2t, which tells us that the constant in front of e to the 2t could actually be positive or negative. Now we can simplify the solution by replacing plus or minus c2 with a new constant c3, which can be any real number that's positive or negative. It just cannot be 0. At this point, we're almost finished, but there's one loose end that we have to tie up. Remember that at the beginning, we assume that y is never equal to 0 for any value of t. But what if the function y is equal to 0 for some value of t? We can answer this question by considering the slope field for our differential equation, and we don't even need to make the entire slope field. Let's imagine for now that y is equal to 0 at some value of t, meaning that its graph touches the t-axis. In that case, we know that at this point, dy dt is equal to 2 times the y-coordinate of that point, which is 0, and so dy dt is just 0. This tells us that the tangent line to the graph at that point must be horizontal. Actually, if we move to any other point on the t-axis, the tangent line would still be horizontal because, according to our differential equation, the slope is always twice the y-coordinate, and the y-coordinate is always 0 along the t-axis. This suggests that if the solution touches the t-axis at any point, then the graph of the solution will be horizontal. Specifically, the solution will be the constant function y equals 0. We can check to see if y equals 0 is a solution to the differential equation by substituting it into the equation. The left-hand side, which I've abbreviated as LHS, is dy dt, and this is 0 for the constant function y equals 0. The right-hand side is 2 times y, so when y equals 0, the right-hand side is also 0. Therefore, y equals 0 is, in fact, a solution. Finally, we can say that even if the constant in front of our formula for y is 0, we'll end up with the solution y equals 0. So we can now let y equal c4 e to the 2t, where c4 represents any real number, including 0. Okay, great. This is the solution, but the constants c2, c3, and c4 were really just labels to help us keep track of our reasoning. Now that we've found the solution, it's simpler to just call the arbitrary constant c and write the solution as c e to the 2t. Alright, we think we have the solution now, but let's check that y equals c e to the 2t is a solution. To do this, we just substitute our formula for y into the differential equation and check if it makes the equation true. Substituting into the left-hand side, we get ddt of c e to the 2t, or in other words, just the derivative of c e to the 2t, and that equals c times the derivative of e to the 2t, which is e to the 2t, multiplied by 2, because of the chain rule. Substituting into the right-hand side, we get 2 times y, which is c e to the 2t, and that's equal to c times 2 e to the 2t, and so the left-hand side and the right-hand side are in fact equal, and our function y is indeed a solution. All that's left is to determine the value of c so that y of 0 is equal to 1. To do that, we can just plug in 1 for y and 0 for t into our function, and this implies that 1 equals c times e to the 0, which is just 1, and therefore that c is equal to 1. And now we solve the problem. The solution is y equals 1 times e to the 2t, or just e to the 2t. Okay, before we talk about a shortcut for solving the kind of problem that we just solved, let's quickly sketch the graph of our solution, y equals e to the 2t. There are a few ways to do this. One option is just to plot a few points. Let's go ahead and do that. When t equals 0, e to the 2t is just e to the 2 times 0, or just e to the 0, which is 1. And when t equals 1, e to the 2t is just e squared, which is approximately 2.72 squared, and that's approximately 7.4. And that gives us two points on our graph, 0, 1, and roughly 1, 7.4, which is about here. Since this is just a transformed version of the graph of e to the t, the graph should look roughly like that, and this matches what we expect from the slope field for the differential equation, which we made in a previous video. By the way, let's just cover a quick point of terminology. What do we call a problem such as dy dt equals 2y together with the equation y of 0 equals 3? We call this an initial value problem in reference to the fact that this equation can be interpreted as giving us the initial value of y. Also, in the context of an initial value problem, what do we call the equation y of 0 equals 3? This is called the initial condition. Lastly, let's learn how to use a shortcut to solve the initial value problem, dy dt equals 1/3 y, subject to the initial condition y of 0 equals 2. Specifically, let's use the formula that we derived earlier to make the problem easier. The argument from before works not only for the equation y prime equals 2y, but also for the more general equation y prime equals ry with any constant r. In that case, the solution is y equals c e to the rt. This formula is worth remembering, and we'll discuss it further in a later video. In the future, if we just remember this formula, we'll be able to solve a given problem easily. For the differential equation dy dt equals 1/3 y, the solution is y equals c e to the 1/3 t, and to find c, we just plug in the initial condition to get that 2 equals c e to the 1/3 times 0, which implies that 2 equals c times 1, so c equals 2. And the solution is y equals 2e to the 1/3 t. All right, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.